Union here, just in case. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So it's a very important question. So the brother was saying, people, the repeated theme in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that Allah guides who He wants. Well, this is a little bit of a technical discussion, but Allah says Allah guides who He wills. Now, what He wants and what He wills, there is a subtle difference in our aqidah. Okay? Now, what does this mean? Let's go back to first principle. So we believe everything happens because of the will of Allah. But there are two aspects to the will of Allah. This is known as the irada qawni and the irada shar'i. Meaning, His legislative will and His ontological will. So His legislative will is the will of what He wants, which is in line with His, with some aspects of His names and attributes. For example, His mercy and His forgiveness. But there is His ontological will, which is everything happens because of His wisdom, but that doesn't necessarily mean it's actually what He actually wants. For example, Allah says in the Quran, Allah prefers belief for His servants, all human beings. The Mufassirin, they say that Allah wants everyone to be guided, but He wills via His ontological will, He wills some people to be guided, some people not to be guided. And some people not to be guided is in line with His divine wisdom, which we may not access. But Allah gives us some spiritual asbab, spiritual causes for why people are not guided. For example, Allah says it around 31 times in the Quran, Allah doesn't guide the arrogant, He doesn't guide the criminals, etc. And this is a very important question because sometimes we think, Allah wants to send people to hell. That's not true. Allah wills people to go to hell. He wants people to go to heaven to be guided. But He wills people to go to hell, which is in line with a divine wisdom which we may not access. And there are spiritual causes, asbab, for why that happens. It could be because we are arrogant, we are criminals, we persist in running away from Allah's mercy. So when you understand the verses in the Quran, Allah says Allah guides whom He wills, it doesn't mean that Allah wants a whole group of people to go straight to the hellfire. He wills them, He wants them to go to paradise, which is based on His, the irada of His, irada qawni, the ontological. It's a little bit of a technical discussion, but the easiest way of putting it is this. It's not the fact that a loving Lord sends people to hell, but rather, why do we choose hell over a loving Lord? That would be the most accurate way of looking at these things. So, but my advice is, because it does require a lengthy topic, is for you to go and read further on this issue. A really good book to go through is Aqidat Hawiyah. You go through a mainstream explanation on the concept of God's will and the two aspects of His will, Irada Qawmi and Irada Sharri. And when you learn that more, you'll understand my Lord is a loving Lord that wants people to be guided, but He wills, in a general sense, what He wills, which is in line with His wisdom. But what He wants is in line with what He prefers. But all of that is still within His will, but there are two aspects to the will. And to learn more, please study. Wallahi, you need to study your deen from that point of view. So I don't know if it answers the questions or brings up more questions. Allah bless you.
Can we, Sheikh, I just want to ask you a question.
Of course, sir.
Okay. Can we say that Allah wants you to do good, but He doesn't interfere with your free choice?
Yes, that's the easiest way of putting it. For example, Allah wants you to do good and go to paradise. We make the choice to actively reject His mercy and guidance. And when you reject His mercy and guidance, you have closed the door. And an absence of Allah's rahmah, an absence of His mercy and guidance, is denied. It's as if you put yourself there. That's why Allah says, those who wrong themselves, don't blame Allah, blame yourself.
Good, I like that. I learned something. Okay, next question.